kan går og dei spora eg trår er kalla som kalla
eg som har
now I got more than enough. And I'm ready for round two on the fire. I'll let the other fire go out after I got done with my tasty tasty. And about ready to settle in for tonight. And the sun is only 3 fingers until it's gone. It's 45 minutes. Heading to the glacier. Well, sun is gone. No more fingers. These are the homemade straps I made for my sleep system, my homemade sleep system. Basically all they are is some straps scavenged from an Alice pack. And what I did was I took the buckles from the Alice pack, and it makes life super easy. I just give it a yank and it locks and they stayed. And the temperature got down into the, I don't know, probably teens the other night. So I thoroughly expected that in the morning when I woke up and packed, that these buckles were going to give way and slip, but they did not. They held tension and everything stayed the way it was supposed to. This literally took me 10 minutes on the sewing machine for an option for my sleep system that will serve me for a long time. Okay, so I'm going to attempt to explain my homemade idea for a 3-layer sleeping bag system. First up is this Austrian sleeping bag. It's dated 1983, and that is the very inside layer of my sleep system. And it's Austrian issue, and why is that significant? I'll get into that in a minute. Now this one here is Swiss. It's dated 1974, and this is a big sumbitch. It's wide and it's roomy. Now this one I made the inside sleep sack, And the reason is because it's got arm zippers. And Saturday night, when I was out there sleeping, I was inside this with my arms sticking out, which means it was between the outer and the inner layer. And it gave me the ability to get out of this thing a whole lot faster. It also gave me the ability to sleep with a pistol in my hand and use it a whole lot better if I needed to. So it's got these zippers on both arms. And I like that. And that fits snugly inside here. And on the inside, up against my body, and I usually crumble it up around my feet to keep my feet extra warm, this is a flex arm poncho liner. The zipper on the Austrian one actually goes down and all the way around the foot area, so you can peel this thing off and wear it like a jacket if you need to. Many people sell these and claiming they're sniper sleep sacks, but they're just a regular Austrian Army issue sleep sack. There's nothing special about it. Everybody got one. And on the very outside, I'm using a British issue MOD DPM bivy sack. I didn't use the bivy sack entirely this weekend because it doesn't have a zipper on it, and me having to evacuate from inside this sleep sack with no zipper and that all the way up to my head, it was problematic. So I just had it down around the bottom part, I guess my legs down, giving me plenty of room to get out if I really needed to. I'm waiting for the zipper to come in from Amazon. It's taken 13 forevers and half of a fucking millennia to get here. Amazon's really slow these days. It's just the way it is. But I did have it around the bottom half of the bag, which is a good thing, because when I was sleeping, my legs slid out from under the Zeltbahn and into the snow, and I woke up with like an inch of snow on top of the bivy bag. So these are the two sleep sacks mated together. And it's the hood. The Swiss one has the hood. I generally will put my boots in there if they're making sure to dry, of course, and fold it over inside the sleep sack right here and use it as a pillow. I'm short. My feet don't even touch the bottom of this thing. So this is what it would have been like trying to sleep in this thing in bear territory with no way out. And that wasn't going to happen. But this is the sleep sack system that I'm going to be using. I think it got down to the teens the other night and I was pretty warm. And this is the sleep system once it's rolled down. It measures about 28 inches across. I couldn't give a full demonstration of the quick pull straps on the account that I don't have a tripod and it wouldn't have came out right. And if you've ever used an Alice pack, you know how handy these little buckles are. And you just give it a yank and it cinches down and it stayed. Sometimes these things wear out and they don't have any tension left in them. So if you're going to do this idea, I would recommend getting a set that are as new as possible. And another item that I'll be using this winter with my sleep kit is one of these German ground sheets. And it's made out of plastic. And it's like a ripstop plastic. I don't know if you can see the little squares. But this thing is super lightweight and you could actually use it as a shelter and pinch if you had to. It's been many years since I've had one of these. They're pretty long. I think it's like maybe 10 feet long. I got it folded in half. But that came in from Finland the other day. And I used it over the weekend. I'm pleased. It's simple. There's no frills about it. And it folds up real easy. It's very non-invasive. If you can get your hands on one of these, I recommend it. I got it from that place in Finland. I can't pronounce the word. I just call it vagina stuka. But I got it from there, I think, for like $15. And the whole order was $10 shipped. So it's a really good place to get kit from. Now this here is a fold-up hard mat. Also from the same place in Finland. This is German Army issue. This holds up to a square. It actually fits in the backing of the German rucksack. It's kind of like a, not a frame, but it keeps the items inside the rucksack from stabbing you in the back. Now, this thing came in super, super handy. You can see in all the pictures, it's sitting in front of the Zeltbahn. It's in between the Zeltbahn and the fire, and that's where I had my ass most of the night, playing with the fire, just relaxing. And it was frozen moss with like 2 months worth of rain under that, and my butt was dry. And another good thing this thing came in handy was And another way this thing came in handy was I had to get up and pee in the middle of the night. So I had myself a little runway, and I had to put my boots on. A little runway to go beside the Zeltbahn and take a pee. Ain't nothing worse than crawling out of a fucking sleep sack. Having to put on your boots, take them off, drag the earth in, snow in with you. But I just got out of my socks and I threw this out and I walked on out, peed, came on back, folded it up, put it by my head. In my opinion, this thing is next to useless as a ground mattress. But it came in pretty handy for everything else this weekend. Okay, so pretty much this is everything, and I put the M4 there for scale.